We have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Get away. 117 to 111. All three in favor of the winner and the new WBC Super Middleweight Champion of the World, Mikael Kessler.
I feel that with Carl, it's gonna be a very good fight. It was a very close fight last time, and that's why we have to train harder this time. I don't care what Carl's doing. He can do whatever he wants. It doesn't gonna help.
Next to the new one, do you mean?
No! Hold nu op, man. Det ved jeg ikke, man. Jeg ved det ikke, man. Det er pisse
bra, man.
Okay. Hej.
Det går alligevel hurtigt. Ja, men du bliver lige sigtet for overtrædelse af færdselsloven. 10.34.
Jo.
Kør 70 i en 50-zone. Så det er et klip i kørekortet også.
Sej. Ja.
Det er simpelthen, du skulle høre os.
Sikker på, at jeg er rigtig glad for min film.
Du får den her på, at vi lige har snakket lidt sammen.
Det er jo den.
Ikke?
Du bliver upopulær i fjernsynet, siger jeg bare til dig. Det kan jeg love dig for.
Jamen, jeg har
også
skrevet
min søster engang,
og også
det må hun heller
ikke tilfreds med.
Ja. En god
dag.
Det er
ordentligt.
Ja, det håber jeg ikke,
du får. Svejl. Sleepy. Now show him you can go faster than that.
Maybe not to talk. He always talks.
I know. I can't make my mouth to put the tape in his mouth.
Yeah, but it's the only way, Jimmy.
Yeah. Focus, focus.
You know, I've had so many fights. I fought the best in the world. Been the best in the world 5 times. I only feel like I'm getting better. Yes, I'm getting older too, day by day. That's how it is.
Look how big legs he has. He's always running from the police.
I can't see myself as the worst fighter ever. I'm getting better and better and better.
You got your mouthpiece, right? No? Okay, I got it.
I have a lot of injuries and I, of course, I lost the fight to Kazaki, and then I have to... I can feel that I'm not getting that hungry anymore when I'm not fighting the best in the world. I have to fight the best or will not be in the game anymore.
Hey, nice shirt.
Hey, Jimmy.
You see? You saw Jimmy? I will knock out Pat Scott.
That our boy.
I know some fighters, they lose everything in one fight. Some, and a lot of fighters, they lose but come back, and that's a real champion. Did it myself a couple of times now. I learned a lot of my mistakes, and I did in those fights. When I fought Galsaki, I had a lot of mistakes in that fight. And it brought me back in a different way. Also, when I lost to Ward, I learned something. To come back, you got to find your own warrior somewhere.
It's showtime!
We didn't know him, but I know he was good. I wasn't there that day at all. I tried to fight him, but he doesn't want to fight. Everything was bad.
Stop, 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 stop. One hold and hit. That was you.
He had many clinches in his fights, but I didn't thought it was that much, and he was a dirty fighter. You know, I didn't think he was that good as he is, so maybe underestimated him a little bit.
Let me tell you something. The media misunderstood him. That wasn't Mikel fighting that night. There was somebody else there, you know?
Body work was great.
What?
Good body work.
Yeah.
Very good.
That one particular night, he was completely off. And there was a lot of disturbance with the commission and with referees, even spies in the gym. Yes, there was a guy that was sparring with him, and then he'd spar a couple of rounds, then go back and spar with Andre Ward, you know, and they would film what he was doing so he could take it back.
When you were down here, yeah. And you went to the body, yeah. Very, very good.
And
then you came short.
Yeah,
and
then, on purpose.
You know, you do it nice. Yeah. That's what, when you do it short, you're not throwing your arms.
Yeah.
Everybody was saying that I was finished. Of course, I doubted myself. Am I really there? Am I really good anymore? I just lost it.
They used to come and tell me, is Mikel finished? I says, what kind of mentality have you got? Don't you know anything about boxing? You can always have a bad night, but Mikel is, he's just coming to his peak.
I have to prove myself then. And fight the undefeated Carl Froch. If I've lost to Carl, then I would have stopped my career.
It was a big fight for me and him. That time, it was my responsibility, nobody else's, to take care of Mikel in the corner.
I was thinking, this is it, now or never. And I remember I saw Carl, he was ready, and I was ready to let's get it on and see who's the champ. And you know what, I thought, if something bad happens, and I gave it all, I trained what I could, and then I'm finished. Then I can say, I retire now. I can feel I don't have it in me anymore, and that's it.
Give me a towel.
Jimmy Montoya, he told me that I was behind on points in the 9th round, remember? I thought, oh, I have to give some more then, you know? And I did, and it maybe turned the fight a little bit.
Michael, you want this title?
Yeah.
Go get the son of a bitch.
You have to get it.
I've seen fights lost because you don't put anything into it on the 12th round. De La Hoya lost to Trinidad because of that.
Vaseline.
There wasn't so much adrenaline pumping in my veins at that time, so of course I thought this could be my last fight, but I'm gonna fight it out. If this is my last round, it is. I'm gonna give it all and see where it brings me. I would give everything I had. I would die in the ring. That's how I felt at the time. It was incredible feeling to have the belt around my waist. How do you call that in English? It was I didn't think the fight was over yet. I couldn't understand that I wasn't in the fight still. My body was hurting so much.
That's
and I woke up the next day and I stood up and I thought, I won yesterday and I have been to a fight, I won, and you know, you have to think about it again. I'm not going to a fight today. No, it was yesterday and I won the fight. It's like a dream sometimes. It's difficult to explain the experience you have in that ring when you're standing with the belt and I am the champ and I'm back, and so I was unbelievable. So now I'm standing here with the belt, and now I have to put my career, stop my career.
And the new WBC Super Middleweight Champion of the World, the Viking Warrior, Mikael Kessler!
I'm standing with the belt, everything is good. And I had some problem with my eyes. I had it coming and going sometimes. It's some nerve that was getting ruined. And after that fight, I tried to spar again. And it came and said, I can't do this. This is, whew. When I get a punch, it's like going. I never tried that before. And I went to the eye doctor, of course, and they weren't very happy. And they said, maybe we don't know if you can operate. We don't know. You have to wait like a year. Maybe you can grow together. And I was lucky, I did after 7 months, I think, 8 months, it started to get better.
Good now, but I don't know in 10 minutes, but now they're good.
I like tattoos because in Denmark they're all Vikings, and I like the mythology and the story of them. Of course, they were not so nice, every one of them, but it's a nice old story. I like the old Vikings. I was 14 actually, but it's erased. It was here once. It said Kessler. Everyone in the boxing club had it, you know? So I gotta have it too. This one is just an evil guy.
Look at this face, he looks like an evil one. You have an alien, I like aliens, you can see outside. So this guy, he put a knife up to the aliens. It's funny, you know?
Will you have any more?
No, it hurts too much.
Please welcome the challenger! The Viking Warrior, Mikael Kessler.
En fast familietradition, at mor Ann går i ringen, når Mikkel bokser. Men denne gang har mor Ann valgt at blive hjemme på Bryggen.
Mikkel er så glad, så glad, så glad. Og så kigger han rundt. Og så kigger han ned på mig, og så siger han, hvor pops? Hun er hjemme, siger jeg. Ja, hun var der jo ikke. Jeg har været meget nervøs i dag. Men Mikkel vandt jo, så det var så dejligt. Nu er det hjem til Bryggen, hvor vi hører til.
Kom. Do you have the girls in the screen?
Yes.
Good. we're a quite famous family, but it started with Mikkel. And then I have very big breasts, so they thought maybe if they could talk to me, Mikkel, and the rest of the family and make a TV show around our family. So we are at the third season now, but in the first season Mikkel was in it. He doesn't really like it.
No.
And he think we are too much in this, I think. Mikkel is totally different from us. He just wants to have his sport and his private life. He's very private. I'm not private at all.
When he was very small, he used to collect pieces of glass on the street because they were diamonds. It was weird, actually.
Yeah, it was very weird. The other boys were playing football in the playground. Mikkel was collecting glasses and
but he played
stones
football.
That were sparkling and artistic. Yeah.
And then he said to me one day, he was almost 13, I'd like to go to boxing. And I said, okay, and two of his friends wanted to, so I called over there and found out what day. And then we went over with your daughter in a pram. And it was really pouring with rain. And when I got over there, I saw a horrible man with a cigar in his mouth tying shoes up at one of the boys. And I thought, and he said, yeah. And I thought, oh, Christ, my little boy's not going to come here. And he said, have you got towels and shorts? Get out and put it on. It was awful. I thought, my poor little shy boy. And that's how it started. And
he was hard, Mikkel. He was really hard and very self, you know, he put rules for himself.
Discipline.
Yeah, disciplined, exactly. He really...
And Richard, his trainer, had said to you, he didn't say it to me, but he said to you that when he was about 17, wasn't he? Where he came out and talked to you and said, it's now or never.
Mikkel had a down period. He was sick and tired of a boxing.
Yeah, and he was being a teenager, and Richard was really worried because he said, 17, 18 years old, they either go on or they stop. I love watching Mikkel fight. Masses of people ask me if I'm nervous or afraid. But I like boxing. I've always liked boxing before I had him. I think it's great sport. You're nervous sometimes.
Yeah, I'm nervous. It's because the fights are so big now. And it's so... and Froch is good.
Yeah, he is.
He's really good. I'm very nervous with Froch.
Well, I've had a weird life. I've been in politics. I've been in different ventures on businesses. I had a ranch, a little farm, like, had a lot of different animals. Animals you wouldn't even imagine in a farm, you know. I even had a couple of chimps. We got a gym in 1964, I think it was, or 62. It was a three floor, so we had 62 fighters or almost 70 fighters living there. My brother got in a little trouble, and I took over the whole thing in 72 or 73, something like that. 74. The best, I think, that of the ones I've trained is like Arguello, Alexis Arguello, Tony the Tiger Lopez, Macho Camacho, Kit Mesa, Richie Sandoval. All these guys became world champions, you know. I've trained a lot of guys. The way it all started with Johnny Bradle. They sent Johnny Bradle to train with me. He was a world champion. And so I started training him, and he brought Mikkel with him. It's a real tough neighborhood. And there were the only white kids around, mostly Mexican and black, and, you know, mostly a mixed group, you know. And I saw Mikkel, you know, and he was, I put him to box. I want to test the little white boy and see what he had, you know. So I put him with Afalabi. He beat Ola, you know, he beat him up. And I said, wait a minute, this kid's got something, you know.
Some bad knocks too. Yeah. Six operations in my hands.
You always have bad days. Some day you have a bad sparring, you know, where you are maybe too tired from yesterday's training. And then you could be, and you and Jimmy and you get mad. And that's how it is in the training, but it's important that we have a very good team.
He was sleeping.
When he was what?
When Anna talked,
oh, really?
Sleeping. So you gotta get up, no breakfast, gotta get up and gotta go.
Okay, well, we'll do just a meet. Work the meet.
But then I can kick a couple. It's no problem for me, you know, but he's tired.
I'm doing it?
Yeah, he's tired. This year of how tired he is.
Yeah, all right. We'll do three rounds maybe or something like that.
You gotta do some rounds.
Yeah.
We always make fun, and we always try to make the training nice so, and not so boring. So it's not the same we do like you did with the old trains. You did the same with jump rope and you are sparring and you have to run. That's it.
Here comes a duel.
This is the clothes he sleeps in. He didn't have time to change.
Sometimes I hate training. But for the most of the time, I love it.
Get him, John. Go get him.
Yeah, hey, make a move, John.
Hey, he's got better moves than Mikkel. Hey, he gave you a better workout than Abdul. Huh?
I have no problem with Carl. He's a fighter, and we both want to be champions, and there can only be one, so that's the problem. You know, it's like if people, they have a pillow fight, you know, when you were younger. You can fight your friend with a pillow, no problem, and you can be friends after. But of course, it's different in boxing. Boxing is a professional job now, and it's your work too. It's a sport, it's a gentleman's sport. You know, you are friends before the fight, you fight, you're not friends. It's only about winning. And then after the fight, you can shake your hand again, you're friends again. That's a real man in my world.
He's got that aggression more now than ever, because he knows that in this game, it's not, you can be friends outside the ring, but once that bell rings, you gotta change your life. There's my time to step in and say, okay, the love is over, man. This is war now.
TV, camera on or no camera?
Ah, no camera, no camera. I don't want him to discover Abdul. Yeah, poor.
Wait!
Just relax. Make a little more. Good, very good. Very good. Angles. That's it. That's how it's got to be done. Under.
I don't hate Carl Frost. Like, I never in the ring I say I hate him. I just want to kill him, because then you can't fight. If you have that, I want to kill him, and I want to. Some people think that way, you know, to get their self up. But you can. You have. This is a chess game.
10 seconds.
You have to concentrate, focus what you've been training on. And Carl is just, it could be somebody else. That's just how it is.
I'm gonna show you something that's gonna work for you real good, babe. Yeah. See, you did a lot of good things.
Yeah.
Because you're thinking.
Inside, just try inside, move yeah. Him, counter.
And open him up. Open like him. One time he, you know, you stayed here, right?
Yeah.
But what I'm trying to tell you is that if you move this like this way,
yeah.
He's gonna turn anyway. He's gonna be the same thing yeah. If you stay here.
Yeah, but until he goes like, must like.
Yeah, yeah.
So you
yeah,
got.
Then, no, you just.
Yeah, but, yeah. But,
no, just lean right here.
Yeah, yeah, but sometimes.
I know, I know, before, if he starts before you can do that, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, but if you catch him before he can do that.
Yeah.
You know, it all depends. Mikel and I will never stop learning. You know, he's got a lot in him. If I ask him to do something in seconds, he'll be doing it. Okay?
Yeah.
I'm getting the best I can out of him. When you got natural talent, it doesn't take long to expose it. You get a guy with natural talent, he can do almost anything.
Carl is a type of fighter, he's slow. You know, he's not fast, and but he's open. He's wide open. But you just can't hit him because he's awkward. The one thing I was surprised about with Carl is he has so long arms. He's going here and he has these long arms, and I thought I was more than away from him in distance, and I got hit. Where did that come from? But you know, I've done a lot of my mistakes in the last fight. Getting hit too much. Actually, I would say I have to get my arms more up and move my head more.
I don't ever feel that I'm the underdog. He makes a lot of mistakes, and we can capitalize on his mistakes. And there's a lot of different ways to deal with a fighter like that. A lot of people might not know, but believe me, we do.
Come on!
Carl, he's coming. He's probably gonna come like a fireball out of his corner. You know, and I get excited about that. I like that. But of course, when I'm standing in the ring, I'm nervous and I don't want to disappoint myself or anybody. I want to show them that I'm the champ.
May 25th, Knockouts aren't predictable, but I'll tell you, I think they happen. It's going to happen on this fight, on our side.
He said to me recently, do you realize this is my last fight? And Mickelson never say that otherwise, would he? And I said, oh yeah, I've heard that before. He said, I mean it. If I lose, or if I don't lose, it's my last fight.
After my eye injury and after the fight against Carl, I only take one fight at a time.
Okay, one more and you're off.
So I'm focused on one fight, only one fight. That's how I am.
Do you think this is a big fight?
I can't say before.
Just two wins over Carl make up for losing to Joe.
So much. What gives you that hunger inside?
I'm focused on Carl Fox. I know it's going to be a hard fight.
Do you think that Carl is a better fighter now?
I'm not going to focus on anything after him.
Is it about proving against Carl we're actually going to fight him rather than boxing?
The fact that you're saying that it could be all over is maybe a little surprising.
I'm going to tell you after what's going to happen.